Hello friends, today we are going to learn 9th standard first poem Life. This poem is written by Charlotte Brontë. So now we will see the line by line explanation of the poem. Life, believe, is not a dream, so dark as sages see. Oft a little morning green foretells a pleasant day. So in this poem, the poet telling us about the life, how to live the life. So life is not like a dream. And it is not so difficult at all, the saints are saying. Says friends, there is a difficulties in our life. Sometimes there are so many difficulties in our life. But we should learn how to tackle with the difficult situation, how to tackle with the difficulties. Because when we tackle with the difficult situation, we come up from it and we live our life successfully. So oft a little morning green, oft means often. Oft means often. Foretells a pleasant day. It could be the indicators of the pleasant day. Sometimes we say that in the morning itself rain it started. So we said that all our days is wasted. But it is not like that. Sometimes this rain could be the indication. It is foretelling or forecasting about the pleasant day. Sometimes there are clouds of gloom. Gloom means sadness. But these are transient all. Transient means temporary. So sadness is also not permanent in our life, and even the happiness is also not permanent in our life. After the sadness, happiness is going to come, and after the happiness, sadness is going to come. So that this is the cycle of our life. If the showers will make the roses bloom, because of the rain, the roses are blooming. Oh, why the laments is called? Laments means expressing the regretness. So why we are telling that rain is not good? Why we are regretting about the rain? Why we are regretting about the sadness? Because after sadness, the happiness is going to come. We should not regret whatever the happen in our life. Okay, so we should not regretting about the past moment. We should see about our future. Rapidly, merrily, life's sunny hours flit by, pass away. Gratefully, cheerily, enjoy them as they fly. So before they are flying, we should enjoy all these moments. And you know what? Sometimes we are enjoying the party somewhere. Maybe 4 to 5 hours we are enjoying the party. And what we are thinking that now only we are coming over here and the party is end. Why? Because these happy moments are flit away very soon. So that we have to enjoy this moment before it is flit away. What though death at times step in and calls our best away? What happen if our death times in step in and calls our best away? That time we feel very sad. What though sorrow seems to win and that time full sadness is come on our mind. Full sadness, our mind is become very sad, our hope a heavy sway. Sway means giving up our hopes. We are all gives our hope because our best away, those the person who are loving us will pass away. And now we are thinking then who will take care of us, who will thinking about us. And now there is no hope of life. There is no life without that person. But yet the hope again elastic spring, unconquered though she fell, still the buoyant are her golden wing, still strong to bear us well. Yet the hope is having like elastic springs. The spring, if we stretch that elastic spring, is coming up again on the same position. So like that, this hope is also having the elastic spring. After sometimes is again come, and because of this golden wings, we forget all the sadness and easily we can start living our life slowly. And still the buoyant means that which can rise upward, and because of the golden wings of hopes, we come upward, we come up from this difficult situation and still strong the bears as well. And because of that, we be very strong person because of the hope, and we started trying towards the goal. Manfully, fearlessly, the day of trial bear, for gloriously, victoriously means soulfully, can courage quell despair. Quell means end, despair means gloom. And all this gloom, all this sadness, because of this hope, will disappear. Because of this gloom, because of this hope, we forget all the sorrow and we come up with that difficult situation and we are trying our level best for the good and nice life. So this is how we have learned this poem. This poem is very interesting. It is written by Charlotte Brome, as I said early. And the central idea of this poem is, through the poem, Charlotte Brome shares her views about the life. She observed that though life may be full of sorrow, this sorrow is temporary. Happiness is always around the corner of the life. Problems doesn't last, but teach us many valuable lessons which last a lifetime, making us stronger and wiser. We should always be optimistic, means positive, fearless, hopeful, courageous, and live life to the fullest. How our lifespan is there, how much the lifespan is there, we have to live our life hopefully. And the poem, like the most of her other work, reflect the difficult time of Brome faced in her life. So that she is always telling us that we should live our life very hopefully. So in this poem, there are so many figures of speech. We will see the figures of speech one by one. Okay, so in the next session, we will see the figures of speech. Thank you, friends.